Okay, we're going to find the least positive angle that's going to be coterminal to the given ones. And we don't want our answers to be the same as the given angles, okay? And what does it mean to have coterminal angles? Well, that means whenever you're given an angle, you're facing one direction, right? You turn so much and then you end up with like this way, maybe. And coterminal means it's going to be a different angle, but then you can turn whichever many times you want. At the end, you'll still be facing the same direction. And we want to find the least positive angle, and that's not going to be the same as the given ones, and that's going to be coterminal to these ones. And let's look at number one. We have 43 degrees. And you can just imagine this. 43 degrees, that means I'm just going to turn a little bit like this, right? So I'm facing that direction. Well, I have to find another angle so that when I start from here and turn so many degrees, I will still be ending up with the same direction. Just imagine this, I'm facing that direction. As long as I can turn this way, another 360 degrees, that's like one loop, just like this. I can still be facing the same direction, right? So I can just go ahead and do 43 degrees, and I just need to add 360 degrees. This right here, which is going to be 403 degrees, at the end, you'll be facing the same direction. Isn't it? And this is the answer. And real quick, let me just show you guys a picture right here. Every time when you're given an angle, this one right here is 43 degrees, right? You are going to start to count right here first. This is your starting position. Okay, this is the zeroth degree. Positive angle, that means you turn this way. And you are just going to turn 43 degrees, so it's going to be like this, something like that. Don't judge my picture, by the way. So this right here is 43 degrees, and this is going to be what we call the terminal side of the original angle, right? Well, this is 43 degrees. And now, you'll see that the 403 degrees, that means we are just going to start from here again. I'm doing this in red. And I will turn, okay, 43 degrees, but I don't want to be the same. So I just have to go another 360. And all in all, I will end up with the same terminal side, isn't it? And this right here is just exactly 43 degrees. And you add another revolution to that, that's it. All right, next we have 815 degrees. You know, this right here, it's bigger than 360 degrees, which is turn a lot already, right? We want to think about how can we just get the smallest angle so that we end up with the same terminal side as this one. You have a few ways to do it. Perhaps the simplest way, in my opinion, to just get the answer right by doing computation is you look at, you know, one revolution, let me just put down one revolution, is 360 degrees, right? And two revolutions, that means you have 720 degrees. And let me just write down a few more for you guys. Three revolutions, this is going to be, you add another 360, so that's 1080 degrees, and so on. Well, this is 815. That means you turn two full revolution already, because you see, two revolutions is 720 degrees, right? And 815 is in between of the second and the third revolutions. Well, in this situation here, I will just take 815 degrees. I will subtract 720 degrees. And now, we just have to do the math for it. This is going to be, well, you can see this is going to be, this is going to be 595, right? 95 degrees. That's all. Seriously, that's it. This is the 95 degrees. Once again, let me draw you guys a picture real quick, okay? So this time, we are starting off with a big angle. Starting from here, right? And now let's keep track. So one revolution, this is 360 degrees, and then you go another revolution, which is now 720 degrees. How many more degrees do I have to turn in order to end up with 815? Well, this is 720 already, right? So from here to here, that's 90. So 720, I add a 90, which is right here, and this is 90 degrees. 720 plus 90 is 810. So here is 810 degrees. we need to end up with 815, so a little bit more right here, something like that, okay? So now you see this is my terminal side. And you see one revolution, two revolution, and then 90 degree, 95 degree more altogether. Well, this is too many terms, it's necessary. So this is the purpose of this kind of equation. You can just go from here, right? You can just go from here. All you need is this 95 degrees. That's all, right? And that's exactly the math that we did right here for you guys. For the negative degrees, it's slightly trickier. Right here, when you have negative degrees, you're turning things backwards, okay? Once again, perhaps if you don't just do computation, look at the revolutions on the side like this. Sometimes you may have to write down a few more, but in this case, it's actually okay. And let me tell you guys a secret to this kind of questions. If the given angle is less than 360 degrees, well, in between of 0 and 360 degrees, this kind of the situation, all you need to do is just add 360 degrees, and that's it. If the given angle, if it's positive and bigger than 360 degrees, you can do things like this and just do subtraction. Another way to get the answer right here is you can divide. Let me show you real quick as well. I can also do 815 divided by 360. And you'll see I need a 2, isn't it? 2 times this is 720. And you subtract, you will get 95. Okay? And the remainder will be the same answer right here. When you have a negative angle, okay, what you are going to do is you're seriously just going to write this down, a few of them, and you're just trying to see this number plus what right here will end up with an angle here that's in between of 0 and 360. Let me show you. This is negative 930 degrees already. This plus that, well, I will not end up with a positive angle that's in between of 0 and 360. This and that is not enough. This and that is not enough. Well, this and that, it's exactly what I need. Let me show you. I'll put this down, negative 930 degrees. I am going to be adding 1080 degrees. Because now I see that when I add them up, I will get a total of 150 degrees, isn't it? And this answer here, it's in between of 0 and 360. If you are not given an angle in between of 0 and 360, just like this one, number 2, number 3, these two angles were not in between of 0 and 360, right? At the end, your answer should be in between of 0 and 360. And you see, this is all I need when I have this different angle, plus one of these numbers here, if I end up with 0, if I end up with an angle right here in between of 0 and 360, that means I'm done. This is the answer, and I'll show you guys real quick with a picture. So, slightly trick here, but let's just keep track. Begin with right here. We have negative 930 degrees, right? So let's go ahead and negative angle, you do it backwards. So you count. This is one revolution, which is negative 360 degrees. Another loop, negative 720 degrees, right? Still not enough. All right, keep track. This is negative 720 degrees already. 90 more backwards. So right now, we will have negative 810 degrees. And then 90 degrees more. This is negative 900 degrees. I need 30 more, so I need to have to be right here, 30 more. So if you draw the picture right here, this right here will be the terminal side. Okay, just count. And yeah, but you see, turn too much, what I can do is starting from here, and I just go from here to here. This right here, as I mentioned earlier, was the additional 30 degree, right? But for the red part, I just had to do altogether is 180 because it's a straight line. 180 minus 30 degrees, let me just indicate this right here is 30 degree, detail angle. 180 minus this little angle, which is 30 degrees, which is going to give us 150 degrees. And that's the same answer that we got earlier. Okay? So you just write this down a few times, and then this is trickier, but you can do it.